Welcome to fourth video with respect to utilization of fatty acids or fatty acid oxidation. So in this video, I am going to talk about a shuttle transport system that is called carnitine shuttle. In case if you haven't watched the previously uploaded three videos, please watch these videos, video 1, 2 and 3 with respect to fatty acid oxidation. Then only you can understand this video much better. Today we are going to talk about transport of activated fatty acid, that is acyl-CoA, into mitochondrial matrix. So imagine this is a cytosol or cytoplasm, and this is outer mitochondrial membrane and this is inner mitochondrial membrane, and in between two mitochondrial membrane is intermembranous space, and below is mitochondrial matrix where exactly beta oxidation takes place. And in the last video we have studied the activated fatty acid, that is acyl-CoA, from the cytoplasm can easily travel outer mitochondrial membrane. Now we have activated fatty acid or acyl-CoA in the intermembranous space. Now this acyl-CoA cannot transported through inner mitochondrial membrane. So for that we require a transport shuttle provided by carnitine. So this carnitine is synthesized by liver and kidney, and its synthesis requires lysine and methionine, two amino acids, and also ascorbic acid or vitamin C is very much essential for synthesis of carnitine. Now this acyl-CoA, or for example if fatty acid is palmitic acid and we can call it as palmitoyl-CoA, it combines with carnitine to form acyl-carnitine, and coenzyme A is released here. Please notice here that this particular reaction takes place in intermembranous space, that is between two mitochondrial membrane. This particular reaction catalyzed by an enzyme which is attached to outer mitochondrial membrane, and this enzyme is called carnitine acyl transferase 1, or simply we can call it as CAT1. So now the fatty acid, that is activated fatty acid acyl-CoA, is converted to acyl-carnitine with the help of carnitine and CAT1. This acyl-carnitine can easily transported across inner mitochondrial membrane with the help of a transporter protein, that is carnitine acyl-carnitine translocase. So this particular translocase is called carnitine acyl-carnitine transport protein. With the help of this protein, which is located in inner mitochondrial membrane and which is a transmembrane protein, this acyl-carnitine easily can transported across inner mitochondrial membrane. Now we have acyl-carnitine in the mitochondrial matrix. So again, this acyl-carnitine should be converted back to acyl-CoA. For this we have an enzyme which is loosely attached to inner mitochondrial membrane, and this enzyme is called carnitine acyl transferase 2 or CAT2. So this enzyme catalyzes conversion of acyl-carnitine to acyl-CoA and carnitine. Please notice here, so we have activated fatty acid which has been activated in the cytoplasm, and now it is in the intermembranous space. Now same acyl-CoA or active fatty acid, for example this fatty acid is palmitic acid and we can call it as palmitoyl-CoA, now which is in mitochondrial matrix. and it releases carnitine, and this carnitine, with the help of this translocase, it will go back to intermembranous space so that it can combine with another acyl CoA, and this settle pathway continues until sufficient amount of fatty acids are oxidized. Now we have activated fatty acid inside the mitochondrial matrix. The further fate of this acyl CoA is called beta oxidation. So all the enzymes are present within the mitochondrial matrix, and this acyl CoA undergo a series of catabolic reaction or oxidation, and we call it as beta oxidation, which I am going to explain in the next video. So please remember, in this video you should know there are two enzymes. One is CAT1, which is attached to outer mitochondrial membrane and helps in conversion of acyl CoA to acyl carnitine, and another carnitine acyl transferase 2, which is attached to inner mitochondrial membrane, which helps in conversion of acyl carnitine to acyl CoA. So this transfer of activated fatty acid from the intermembranous space to the mitochondrial matrix with the help of carnitine is called carnitine shuttle or carnitine transport system. So in the next video we are going to study about the proper beta oxidation, which takes place in mitochondrial matrix. Thanks for watching.